in Asbury live from the Loose Center here in Wilmore, Kentucky. It's a big matchup as it is the battle for first place in the KAC South Division. Both teams are 6-2 in the conference. Also, CCU comes in with an 18-7 record, while Asbury is 17-7, so the winner of this game will be in first place in the KAC South. Looking at both these teams, they both love to score a lot of points. Cincinnati Christian was once nationally ranked last week. They were actually ranked 19th in the nation. They are now in the receiving votes column, but they average 76 points per game. Look at Asbury, they're averaging 84 points per game. It'll be a tall order tonight for the Eagles, though, with Kyle Lamb being out for the year. Also, CJ Penny out for this game with a hip flexor injury, as those are the top two scorers for Asbury, so it's going to be tough for the Eagles. They're going to have to rely on other players to put in points for the game for Asbury. All right, now we're going to go to a highlight recap of the women's game, in which they dominated Cincinnati Christian 95-62. So we are 1-12 away from the opening tip between Cincinnati Christian and Asbury. What should be a very exciting game. Taking a look at CCU in the warm-ups, they got some size and they can really shoot the three ball. Asbury being a couple men down, this is going to be a tough game for them. But it will be possible. It's not all lost yet. Game hasn't even started. Not to mention Asbury, undefeated at home here at the Loose until Saturday. Actually, they lost their first game at home to Indiana University East. All right, and here we go. We got Kylie Gorby alongside with us now. Inside 30 seconds for the opening tip. We're going to find out the starters for both teams.
Good evening, welcome to the Center on the campus of Asbury University for tonight's basketball game between Cincinnati Christian Eagles and your Asbury University Eagles. Now let's meet the starters. First CCU, number 12, Nick Siebert. Number 13, Kenny Gaynor. Number 21, Mitch McLeish. Number 30, DJ McCommons. And number 33, Drew Shelton. CCU is coached by Kellen Sawadaski.
And now the starters for your Asbury University Eagles. A sophomore from Warsaw, Kentucky, number 2, Christian Morgan. A freshman from Nicholasville, Kentucky, number 3, Dalton Peters. A junior from Maysville, Kentucky, number 10, Jordan Gilbert. A sophomore from Lexington, Kentucky, number 24, Tyler Smith. And a junior from Brooksville, Kentucky, number 30, Todd Jefferson. Asbury is assisted by Russell Abner and Eric Davis, and the head coach of the Eagles in his seventh season is Will Shouts.
All right, so the starters for Asbury, it'll be Christian Morgan, Dalton Peters, Jordan Gilbert, Tyler Smith, and Todd Jefferson. Starters for CCU, Seibert, Gaynor, McLeish, DJ McCommons, and Drew Shelton. And here's the opening tip. And it goes to Asbury. It's Jordan Gilbert to bring the ball up the floor for the Eagles. Gilbert, a long three. It's good, Jordan Gilbert. It's a good start for Asbury. And Mitch McLeish, the former Asbury player, transfer now over to CCU. McLeish is the leading scorer also for the Eagles. Seibert. He's going to fire a three, no good. Rebounded by Tyler Smith. Comes Asbury now in transition. Jefferson back out to Morgan. And Jordan Gilbert now to set things up on offense. Christian Morgan's shot is no good. DJ McCommons bringing it up the floor now for CCU. Shelton, the three, wide open, it's no good. Todd Jefferson comes up with the rebound. Peters thought about the three, gives it back to Gilbert. Now Peters will take the three on the wing, too strong. Jordan Gilbert's there for the offensive rebound. Jefferson. Over to Gilbert. Gilbert kicks it out. Jefferson a three. It's not there. McLeish with the board. Good ball movement. It's over to Seibert. A three-pointer. It won't fall, though, and Tyler Smith comes up with it. Peters a three. In transition, it falls. Good start for Asbury. It's 6-0.
Great start for Dalton Peters, which is his first game starting this season. CJ Penny being out with a hip injury.
A tall order indeed for Asbury with no Kyle Lamb or CJ Penny, but it's a good start, 6-0, 17-33 here in the first half.
We see Asbury playing a zone. Because of their lack of size with Penny out, they're trying to force the three-point.
There it is, Seibert. He knocks down the three. That's the first three and the first basket for CCU. There's Jordan Gilbert now the other way. Tyler Smith trying to create, it won't fall. There's Shelton with the board. Back over to McCommons. Good pass from McLeish to Seibert. In and out on the three. Tyler Smith comes up with the rebound. It's taken away. It's McLeish. Pull up three. Too strong. And Tyler Smith, another rebound. Christian Morgan in traffic. Kicks it out to Gilbert. Mid-range jumper. It's good. Jordan Gilbert. Good start for him. He's got 5 points. And with 16:35 to go in the first half, it's a full timeout taken by CCU. And it's 8-3 Asbury. Kylie, what have you seen so far from Asbury that you've liked?
I like the leadership that Jordan Gilbert's showing. I know Coach Schaus had talked to him, and with Kyle Lamb being out and CJ Penny being out, he's required to step up and take more of an offensive role on. We saw last game, he actually has career high in shot attempts, which was 12. He's a facilitator, he moves the ball around, but now he's having to step up into his offensive position. So, impressive start from him.
As for CCU, not much is falling. They've been taking a lot of three-pointers. Only one has gone. That was Seibert who hit the three. We'll look to see that CCU is going to take a lot of threes. See if Asbury is going to continue to give them those threes. If they do fall, I imagine Asbury might switch out of the zone. But right now, the zone seems to be working.
CCU with the definite height advantage. So I think it's a great decision to drop back into that zone because they can beat you inside, and you can let them live or die by the three, and they're taking that risk tonight.
Like I said in the pregame, this is a huge game for both teams. Both teams tied for first place in the KAC South Division. The winner of this game will have sole possession of first place. So we're back to the action now. Asbury with a 5-point lead and a good start. McLeish now to bring it up the floor. Over to McCommons. High extended zone here from Asbury. Mid-range jumper. That is good from Kenny Gaynor. It's a 3-point lead now for the Eagles. Christian Morgan, 3-pointer short. Ball is loose. Mitch McLeish comes up with it. Good pass inside. There's Gaynor again. Short range jumper. It falls. It's now a 1-point game with 15:40 to go in the opening half. Morgan finds Jefferson, a 3, in and out. Now McCommons to push. Shelton over to Seibert. Gaynor's shot, not quite there. Tyler Smith with another rebound. That's his 5th of the game. Smith gonna drive in traffic and he draws the foul. Well, Tyler Smith leads Asbury with 7.8 rebounds per game. He's already got 5. We got 15:06 to play here in the first half. Smith's free throw is no good. Now Willie McKinney and Jarrell Moses will check in for CCU. Tyler Smith is a 69% free throw shooter on the season. He gets the second one to go. That's his first point of the game. And Asbury leads it 9-7, 5 minutes in here in the first half. High extended 1-3-1 zone, it looks like, from Asbury here on the defensive end. There's McKinney inside. A nice move there from Willie McKinney, the freshman, or the senior, out of Dayton, Ohio.
Cincinnati Christians clearly recognize their advantage. The past 3 possessions, they've gone inside the paint.
With the clear size advantage, I imagine they're going to continue and try and do that. Gilbert finds Morgan. Looks it over to Peters. There's Gilbert, a 3. And Jordan Gilbert drills a 3. He's had an excellent start. It's now 8 points for Gilbert and a 3-point lead for the Eagles. They're going to need a big game from Gilbert, especially with no C.J. Penny tonight. That's a nice ball movement, and there's Willie McKinney again inside. Gilbert finds Smith in the middle of the paint, and an excellent finish from Tyler Smith. That's going to be a turnover, a double dribble on Jarrell Moses. Now Massey checks in for CCU as Seibert will take a seat. Drew Shelton comes back in for Kenny Gaynor.
We also see Christian Svensson, the JUCO transfer, coming into the game for the Asbury Eagles.
Jordan Gilbert with it. Back over to Tyler Smith, to Peters. Right back to Smith inside. Not much there. Smith tried to create, couldn't get it to fall. Here's McLeish the other way now. They continue to go inside. Shelton missed an easy shot. In transition now, Asbury. It's Christian Morgan. He just kind of threw it up. Tyler Smith with the offensive board. Ball's on the ground, and Christian Morgan comes up with it. and kick it out to Peters. Peters a three. It's good. Dalton Peters.
Dalton Peters off to another great start. He's been a little rough patch here. Coach is expecting a lot of offense out of him. In the past previous three games, he had gone 0-for-12 from the three-point line, but he's hit two quick early in this game.
That's the fourth three already for Asbury. That's a six-point lead. 12:45 to go in the first half. Here's McLeish. They're going to call a foul. Looks like on Gilbert. Now Will Henderson and Alex Dennis come in for Asbury. McLeish takes a seat for CCU. The Commons are throwing the inbound. Fresh 35 for CCU to try and create something. Moses passes inside McKinney. He got it and the foul. McKinney's dominating inside with the clear size advantage as he stands tall at 6'7". It's now 6 points for McKinney. First foul on Svensson. McKinney's free throw is good and the lead is back now to 3 for Asbury. Here's Christian Morgan. Now Peters. Over to Dennis. Asbury staying across the perimeter as now Peters drives to the basket and he draws a foul. It's going to be on Massey for a hold. Second team foul now on CCU. 12 minutes left exactly in the first half. Peters to take it out. Inbounds it to Henderson. Now Dennis, a three on the wing. Not quite there. Rebounded by McKinney. McCommons driving inside, and he got it. Nice play from DJ McCommons. 1 point lead for the Eagles. Peters, another three. It's no good, but Will Henderson comes up with the offensive rebound. There's Morgan driving to the basket. Gets his own rebound. Goes back up, it's blocked. Henderson, mid-range jumper. It's going to be an air ball. Morgan saved it, but it goes into the hands of Shelton. Now McCommons the push for CCU. McKinney comes up with it. Now CCU to set it up. Now we're going to kick it back. It's Moses, a three. It's good. Jarrell Moses drills the three. And CCU has their first lead of the game. It's 19-17 with 10:50 to go. Dennis, three-pointer. It's no good. Peters saves it. But once again, it goes into the hands of CCU. McCommons, a pull-up three. It's good. DJ McCommons nails the three, and it's now a five-point lead for CCU.
McCommons is a very crafty player. I've been watching him for a couple years now. He looks a little out of shape, but he's deceptively fast, and he can create his own shot.
CCU now shooting 53% from the floor, and it's starting to show as now they have a five-point lead with 10.5 to go. Tyler Smith back over to Henderson, a three-pointer, no good. Massey with the rebound over to, once again, to McCommons. Set things up on offense. Asbury still sticking with their zone defense. McKinney harassed by Smith and Morgan. And what a play by Tyler Smith. He comes up with the steal. In transition, tried to find Jack Schmidt. Last off of CCU.
The Asbury Eagles are clearly going way down their bench tonight with not their usual starting lineup. And we see players who are only averaging 4 or 3 minutes on the season getting some action. So excited to see what they can do.
Schmidt inbounds to Henderson. Give it back to Schmidt. Over to Svensson. Morgan going to drive to the basket. Oh, what a take by Christian Morgan. It's his first points of the game. And the lead is now 3 for CCU with 9:35 to go. Commons now, just holding the ball. He'll swing it over to Shelton. And Moses over to Massey. The Commons a 3. No good. Schmidt fighting for the rebound with McKinney. It's going to be a jump ball. Possession arrow is going to favor CCU.
Impressed that Schmidt was able to hold on to that ball there.
Yeah, absolutely. More substitutions from both teams. Todd Jefferson, Dalton Peters back in the game for Asbury. Seibert also in, along with Gaynor for CCU. Here's McLeish with it. And find McCommons. Over to Seibert. And a swing pass all the way over to Massey. Dangerous pass, and it's a turnover. Will Henderson with it. Finds Tyler Smith. And Tyler Smith does an excellent job there driving baseline to draw the foul. He'll go to the line for 2.
Tyler Smith bringing a lot of energy tonight. We see him initiating that steal down there. Got a steal earlier. 7 rebounds, I believe, on this game already. He's attacking the basket very hard, drawing some fouls on the big men.
Yeah, with your top 2 scorers out for Asbury, they're going to need a whole total team effort, especially against a very good CCU team. Smith's free throw is good. That gives him 4 points on the night. Jordan Gilbert comes back into the ballgame. Smith knocks down both free throws. The lead is now 1. It's 22-21 with 8:45 to play in the first half. Asbury now throwing up a half-court trap defense. Now they'll fall back into their zone. And Massey stepped out of bounds. That'll be a turnover. And that'll be the 4th on the Eagles tonight.
Ironically, the Asbury Eagles are out-rebounding Cincinnati Christian right now, which is surprising considering the height disadvantage.
Yeah, Asbury going with a smaller lineup, mostly guards outside of Tyler Smith and Jefferson, who's a forward. Gilbert swings it over to Peters. Jefferson now gives it back to Gilbert. Oh, what a move by Gilbert. Couldn't quite get it, but Tyler Smith is there, but he missed it. Second effort, Smith fighting for it. Nice play by Kenny Gaynor to give it to McLeish. Now in transition is Robbie Williams. McCommons, it's going to be a foul on Asbury. I think they're going to call it on Todd Jefferson. Nope, they're going to call it on Schmidt. Third team foul for Asbury. Neither team really fouling much. Here's Williams with it. Seeing his first action tonight. McCommons inside to Gaynor. Siebert, he loves to shoot the 3. No good. But it goes into the hands of Williams, and that's going to be an offensive foul, I believe.
Todd Jefferson just always willing to take a charge. Last game, he had 4 charges in 1 game. And for those of you who may or may not know basketball, taking 4 charges in 1 game, that's a very impressive stat there.
Well, 7:40 to go now. Asbury only down by 1. Peters, 3 on the wing. It's good. Dalton Peters has shown up tonight. That's his 3rd 3 of the game. Asbury now back out in front, 24-22. Here's McCommons. Swinging it over to McLeish. Leading scorer for CCU. He's been quiet. He hasn't scored at all. Seibert picks up his dribble, swings it over to Williams. Good defense here from Asbury. Gaynor, mid-range jumper, short. There's Tyler Smith, yet another rebound. That's his 10th of the game. Schmidt shot that long range. It's no good. And here comes CCU the other way. Siebert swings it over. Williams, he goes baseline, kicks it out to Gaynor. Good ball movement from CCU. Now McLeish is going to get a screen from Gaynor. Seibert inside to Gaynor, and good play from Kenny Gaynor. And we're now tied at 24 with 6:23 to play. Back and forth we go. Good pass from Gilbert. Smith on the mid-range jumper. It's good. Tyler Smith, he's having a heck of a game. That's 7 points and 10 rebounds. And with 6:14 to go, we got a full timeout on the floor. Asbury leading it 26-24. It's been an exciting game, Kylie. What have you seen from really either team that's sticking out to you so far?
Tyler Smith, it's clear to anybody that he's playing with a ton of energy. Very likely to have a double-double here in the first half, which I don't believe he's done all season. He's coming out, he's playing hard, and he's making up for the two players that we have out tonight. Christian Morgan, also another player that I'm seeing attacking the basket really well. The Eagles are controlling the pace of the game right now, but they need to be expecting for CCU to come out very hard and aggressive. Mitch McLeish, a leading scorer, hasn't scored yet, so we can expect a lot of shots from him in the second half and the closing of this half.
Hey, you look at the field goal percentage. Asbury really not shooting the ball very well, just 9-27 from the floor, but they got a two-point lead. They've also knocked down five threes. Dalton Peters has had a big game. He's already made 3 three-pointers. They're going to need a lot from him. Jordan Gilbert's played very well. I mean, just about everyone on the floor has contributed in some way, and they're going to need that to beat a very good CCU team who was, like I said earlier in the pregame, once nationally ranked just a couple of weeks ago.
Asbury also has been in several offensive rebounds, and that's resulted in them having 7 more shot attempts.
All right, so 6:14 left in the first half. It's been an exciting game so far, Asbury by 2. Asbury now going to set up a full court trap defense. Commons swings it all the way over to Williams, and he'll get across the half court line with ease. Seibert inside McLeish. He lost it. And it's going to be a turnover. It's good defense from Asbury. It's a 6th turnover now from CCU. There's Morgan over to Tyler Smith. Gilbert over to Peters. Asbury running their offense across the perimeter. Now Smith going to drive to the basket. He'll throw up a shot. He'll go to the line for 2 more free throws. Tyler Smith has been the dominating force inside for Asbury so far. Now CCU is going to send in their big Willie McKinney and try and limit Smith. Smith at the line. The free throw is no good. Just the 2nd missed free throw for Asbury. They're now 3 of 5 from the line. Tyler Smith, the sophomore from Lexington, Kentucky, knocks down that 2nd free throw. And that gives them 8 points on the night. And Asbury now out in front by 3. 5.5 left in the first half. McCommons thought about the 3. Said he gives it to Gaynor, who gives it right back to McCommons. Now Seibert inside to McKinney. He's going to try and work on Smith. Jefferson in there to collapse on him. There's McLeish, a mid-range jumper. It's good, and Mitch McLeish is on the board for CCU. Smith over to Morgan. Kick it out to Gilbert, a long 3. He got it. Jordan Gilbert, he's feeling it. And that's double digits, 11 points now for Jordan Gilbert.
Total team effort by Asbury tonight. Not a player on the court playing poorly.
That was a great job by Christian Morgan to penetrate and then kick it out to Jordan Gilbert. And Asbury's 3-point shooters are feeling it. That's 6 threes already. Here's McCommons. Mid-range jumper from the elbow is good. That's 7 points on the night for DJ McCommons. 2-point game, 30-28, 4.5 to go. Gilbert going to drive to the basket. Nice pass inside Smith. It's blocked partially by Seibert. He'll stay with Asbury, though. Peters to take it out now for Asbury. Now in the hands of Christian Morgan. Back over to Gilbert, pump fake. Thought about the three, said he'll give it over to Christian Morgan now. And Morgan draws a foul. It's gonna be on McLeish. It's his second foul, that's big. He might have to come out here for the rest of the first half, and he will. They're gonna bring in Jameel Butts. Actually, they're gonna keep, no, yeah, McLeish is gonna go off. He's got two fouls, and he'll sit the rest of the half. Now Jordan Gilbert with it. Gonna drive right side. Trying to be a little too fancy, and it's a turnover with 4 minutes left. DJ McCommons now with it. That's the fourth turnover for Asbury. It's McKinney back over to Seibert. There's Butts, a three. Too strong, McKinney with the easy board. There's Jefferson, and like you said, forcing another charge. That's a turnover.
Second charge of the game, six charges in the past two games.
Asbury being able to do it anywhere on the floor on offense and defense. They're holding on to a two-point lead, 3:40 left. There's Smith, long two.
And Smith with a double-double here in the first half now, 10 points and 10 rebounds.
And Tyler Smith has been the biggest player overall for Asbury, but it's been a total team effort. 4-point lead with 3:31 to go, as you saw there on the highlight. Tyler Smith's long two to give him a double-double with still 3 minutes to go in the first half. Seibert inside to McKinney. Over to Butts. Going to go inside now to Gaynor, working his way. He's double-teamed by Jefferson and Peters. CCU running the ball now across the perimeter. 10 seconds to shoot. Butts with it with now 5 seconds. McCommons, crossover on Morgan. He'll just throw it up, in and out, and it's rebounded by Tyler Smith. Here comes Smith the other way. We're going to call foul on CCU. I think it's going to be on Butts, and it is. I'm calling for a hold on Todd Jefferson. And that is now the seventh team foul, so Asbury will be in the bonus the rest of the way.
Asbury needs to look to take advantage of the bonus right now here towards the end of the half. Draw fouls, get to the free throw line, and get easy points.
Jefferson hits the free throw. He's a 77% free throw shooter on the season. And that's Jefferson's first point of the night. A 6-point lead now. Commons pushes ahead the half-court line over to Butts. Gaynor swings it over to Seibert. McKinney wide open down low, and he missed the layup. And it's last off McKinney. It'll be Asbury ball. 2:32 to go in the first half, a 6-point lead, 34-28. Christian Morgan, he lost it, ball's on the ground, and it's taken away by Seibert the other way. And a nice lefty layup from Seibert. It's a 4-point game. Asbury quickly pushing ahead. Jefferson back to Smith. Now they're gonna give it to Gilbert to slow things down and set something up. Inside 2 minutes in the first half. There's Morgan kicking it out to Gilbert. Nice pass. Inside, Jefferson, he missed the layup though. Rebounded by McKinney. An excellent outlet pass to Drew Shelton. And it's now a 2-point game, 1:35 to go. Smith's shot is no good. They're gonna call jump ball. It'll stay with Asbury. minute and a half to go, and CCU coaching staff didn't like that call. Morgan to take it out. Finds Jefferson. Back to Jordan Gilbert. Here's Jefferson's three. He got it. Excellent shot from Todd Jefferson. That's a 7-3-pointer for Asbury, and it's a 5-point lead. McCommons, look over to Butts. Under a minute to go now, 15 seconds on the shot clock. Seibert, baseline three, no good. The 12th three-pointer for CCU. They've only made three of them. Jordan Gilbert to slow it down. On the wing now is Morgan. 40 seconds left here in the opening half. Smith going to kick it out to Morgan. Gilbert, a long three. No good. Dalton Peters tried to save it, but it went out of bounds. And so the shot clock is off with 30.6 to go. CCU will hold it for the last shot. Now the Eagles are going to bring in Mitch McLeish. Drew Shelton will take a seat.
Expecting McLeish to take the last shot of this half.
McLeish has had a quiet night, but he's still the team's overall leading scorer through the course of the year. Now McCommon's just going to hold it. Commons, a nice pass inside. McKinney with the finish. Gilbert's long shot is short. It's a 3-point lead, though, for Asbury at the half, 37-34. It's been a highly entertaining first half. Overall, what have you seen so far, Kylie, that's really stuck out to you in the first half?
Well, we see the bench stepping up for Asbury tonight. Coming in, taking care of the ball. Not a lot of points action, but they're moving the ball and helping create baskets. We also see, again, Tyler Smith can't help but to talk to him. 11 rebounds, 10 points, incredible first half with a double-double. The whole team, it's just a team effort. There's not a person on the court that's really, truly playing bad. As far as CCU goes, we see Mitch McLeish with a light first half. We can expect him to come out gunning in the second half because when you're a leading scorer, you're not really happy with 2-4 points.
All right, now we're going to go quickly to the highlight video from the first half. First half, Asbury holding on to a 3-point lead. We'll be back for the second half shortly, so stay tuned. All right. and welcome back to the Luce Center for the second half between Asbury and Cincinnati Christian. We're just about 2 minutes away from the second half starting. So far in the first half, it's been an exciting first half. 37-34 Asbury by three. Kylie, what does Asbury need to do to hold on to win this game in the second half?
They need to make sure to get back in transition. Towards the very end of that first half, we saw CCU get four quick baskets just off not getting back. You could tell they were getting a little exhausted. And they need to keep bringing the intensity that they brought in the first half.
Looking at the stats, Asbury's done an excellent job shooting the ball from three-point range. Nearly 50%. They made seven threes so far. That's going to be a big key, along with the total team effort like we were talking about in the first half. The biggest player obviously sticking out so far is Tyler Smith with 10 points and 12 rebounds. We still have another half to go, and he's already put up monster numbers. As for limiting CCU, it'll be, you know, continuing to stop Mitch McLeish, their leading scorer. They held him just 2 points in the first half. However, CCU is shooting 50% from the floor. But the three-pointers are not really falling, just 3 of 12. So far from beyond the arc.
Well, Asbury has been living by the three-point line here in this game. We see CCU with 16 points in the paint compared to Asbury's four. So hopefully Asbury can keep the hot hand in the second half.
Yeah, CCU has size with McKinney and Gaynor as well. Both of them are 6'7". Asbury doesn't have a whole lot of guys who can really guard him. So it'll be interesting to see what happens as the second half about to start. Be the same people who started in the first half. For Asbury, it's Christian Morgan, Dalton Peters, Jordan Gilbert, Tyler Smith, and Todd Jefferson. For CCU, it's Seibert, Gaynor, McLeish, McCommons, and Shelton.
Seems like CCU may have got ripped by their coach during halftime because they're just now getting out here on the court.
Yeah, he doesn't look happy walking over to the sideline there.
I'd say the coaching staff definitely wasn't expecting this game with Asbury's two leading scorers
out.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Just shows how much depth they do have.
Well, one more half to go, but Asbury with the upset right now, a three-point lead early on in the second half. It's McCommons over to Shelton. Seibert finds McLeish, and a foul. It's going to be on Dalton Peters, I believe, and yes, it will. His hands on McLeish there. That'll be the first foul, just 11 seconds in the second half.
McLeish with only 2 points in the first half, looking to attack here early in the second half.
Seibert, there's McLeish, a three, short, and Jefferson comes up with the rebound. Well, CCU loves to shoot the three-pointers. They've already taken 13 of them. They've only nailed three of them, though. So Asbury needs to continue to let him shoot those because clearly they're not falling tonight. Here's Morgan over to Gilbert. Jefferson, a three with the hand in the face. It's too strong. Rebounded by McLeish. Here's Seibert inside to Gaynor. Good job by Asbury to double team. Dangerous pass. Seibert comes up with it. Here's McCommons, a mid-range jumper. It's good. It's DJ McCommons. He has 9 points and back to a one-point lead for Asbury. Here's Smith, top of the key, over to Jefferson. Kick it out to Morgan. He's going to drive. Short jumper, no good. There's Jefferson with the offensive rebound, but he lost it. Here's Gaynor with the steal. Now McLeish ahead to Shelton and a foul. It might be on Peters again, and it is. Another quick foul on Dalton Peters. That's the second team foul for Asbury, and that's the second foul on him.
Not sure I necessarily agree with that call, but once again, not sure that my opinion matters here.
Now you saw on the replay, there really wasn't a whole lot of contact there. Inside Shelton just pretty much threw it at the rim. Peters with the rebound, and now Smith bringing it across. Here's Jordan Gilbert. A nice crossover. Head over to Christian Morgan. Asbury slowing it down. CCU playing well defensively here early on in the second half. 5 seconds to shoot now for Morgan. Morgan to drive to the basket. He's blocked by Gaynor, but a foul. Good job there from Christian Morgan to create something out of nothing in what was really a pretty bad possession. He'll now go to the line for two free throws. Gaynor there got Morgan on the arm coming down. Morgan's first free throw was good. That puts Asbury now 7 of 9 from the line tonight. So definitely taking advantage of the freebies.
You notice that Asbury slowed down the ball movement here early in the first half. In the second half. In the first half, they're moving it around the perimeter very quick, and now they're kind of holding it 3 or 4 passes of possession.
So Morgan nails both. Asbury now with a 3-point lead with 17:35 to play in the second half. McLeish, a nice pass to Seibert. He missed a short-range jumper, though. Jefferson the rebound. Over to Gilbert. Peters. Three-pointer, no good. McCommons with the board. McLeish now going inside to Gaynor, working in on Peters. Oh, what a move, and what a finish. Kenny Gaynor using the glass. That's 8 points for Gaynor. And the lead now is 1 for the Eagles. Gaynor pushes Jefferson, no call. What a steal right there from DJ McCommons. He's going to go in transition by himself all the way to the basket. And CCU is now back out in front, 40-39. It's Jefferson over to Christian Morgan. Jefferson's open. He's going to let a three go. He got it. Todd Jefferson, his second three of the night.
Big shot by Todd Jefferson there. CCU with the momentum right now. Great to see a little stop to that run.
The 8-3-pointer for Asbury. Now they're back out in front now, 42-40. 16:15 to play in the second half. McCommons thought about the three. He'll swing it over McLeish. 3-point shot, now no good. McLeish struggling so far, just 2 points. Smith the other way in transition. Kicks it out, Peters. Another three. Booyah! A 5-point lead for Asbury. And with 15:57 to go in the second half, the Eagles lead it by 5. Got to say, Asbury is really shooting the three ball well. That's now the 9th three-pointer of the night.
Dalton Peters, 4th three-pointer of the night as well.
Yeah. He's really played well. All of his points have come from three-pointers. He's nailed 4 of them, like you said. That's 12 points. Swing pass over to Seibert. McLeish trying to drive baseline on Smith, and they're going to call quick touch foul, Tyler Smith. It's now the 3rd team foul now on Asbury. First foul on Smith. McKinney's now going to come back in. And Gaynor will take a seat. Inbound to McLeish. Gives it back to Seibert inside to McKinney. Asbury doing an excellent job on the defensive end, getting into everyone's face. Seibert swings it over McCommons. Shot fake, and now we'll step into a three, and the bank is open. He didn't even think that one was going in. DJ McCommons now double figures. He's got 11. 2-point game, 15:15 to go. Peters, nice pass to Smith. Driving baseline, that's a foul on McKinney.
Smith has no fear when he's driving in at those big men. He goes right into their chin with it.
Tyler Smith with 13 rebounds already. He's also got 10 points. He's been a big catalyst for Asbury inside, as they don't really have much of a post presence without CJ Penny tonight. Second free throw from Smith. It's good. 4-point lead, 15:09 to go, second half. Asbury now in that Full court pressure defense. Moses. Over to McLean. Off the knee of Shelton. That's a turnover. And that is the eighth on CCU. Alex Dennis comes in for Tyler Smith, who will take a seat for a few minutes. See what Asbury does now in offense with Tyler Smith not being there down low, but good job by Christian Morgan driving to the basket. He's done a nice job of that tonight, driving to the basket into the lane and creating fouls.
I'm really liking the way that Asbury is attacking the basket this half. They are shooting great from the three-point line. Can't take that away from them, but you have to have another aspect to the game, and they're providing that here in the second half.
Morgan gives it back to Peters. Wide open baseline. Reverse layup good. And Asbury with a six-point lead now with 14:35 to play in the second half. McLeish. Good off to Moses, right back to him. Now McCommons. McLeish stepping into that three. He's cold tonight. That one won't fall. Morgan in transition to Peters. Good pass to Dennis and the finish. Excellent offense, transition offense from Asbury. And now their largest lead, an 8-point lead with 14:10 to go. And McLeish the other way swings it. Moses, a three. No good. There's Morgan. Asbury likes to push. Peters. He got it again. Dalton Peters, his fifth three-pointer tonight. And an 11-point lead. My goodness. It's a 10 three-pointer for Asbury, and it's an 11-point lead with 13:57 to go in the second half.
Dalton Peters leading the Asbury Eagles with 17 points. Biggest game of his career.
All right, Kylie, so Asbury's obviously shooting the three ball extremely well. What else have you liked that they've done either on the offensive or defensive end so far?
Well, I like the way they're attacking the rim. They didn't do that as much in the first half. We saw Smith getting rebounds and getting putbacks, but we didn't see the guards attacking. We see Dalton Peters with a great drive. We see Jordan Gilbert driving and dishing. We see Christian Morgan getting to the line. I really like the way they're playing, and I really like that they're making CCU shoot from the outside.
Well, CCU's really struggling so far in the second half, just 9 points here. And Asbury's done an excellent job on the defensive end, really putting all kinds of pressure on CCU to really even get any decent looks. And it also helps that Mitch McLeish, like we've said, their leading scorer, really struggling tonight, just 2 points. He's really not feeling it at all. So Asbury now with an 11-point lead, and, you know, CCU looks a little startled. I don't think they were expecting Asbury, especially like we said earlier with no Kyle Lamb or C.J. Penny, to really be this competitive. But here's Asbury with a double-digit lead. Still a lot of time left, but things are looking really good here.
Well, when you look back on Asbury's last game against Indiana East, they didn't play very well. Things didn't run as smoothly. And it's easy to overlook a team when you look at the scores, but it just proves to show how competitive this conference is. There's four teams with two losses now. Anybody can win on any given night.
All right, so back to the action now. Asbury, like we said, with an 11-point lead, it's 54-43. Commons bringing it up now for CCU. Swings it over to Butts. One-three-one zone from Asbury. McCommons on the wing. Good job from Asbury. Not giving any good looks, and there's a turnover. Bad pass. Nearly lost the TV monitor there as Jarrell Moses tried to save the ball. Now the ninth turnover for CCU. Here's Peters, swings it over to Dennis. Now Christian Morgan driving to the basket. He lost it. They're going to call a foul. Call that on Moses. Be the fourth team foul now for CCU. Denzel Harrington will check in for the first time tonight. And Seibert will take a seat for CCU. Peters to inbound. He'll throw it nearly to the half court line to Jefferson. Now here's Gilbert. Gilbert a three. Too strong. We're going to call a foul, and it's going to be on Drew Shelton. a hold on Todd Jefferson. So with 13:09 to go, Asbury going to get another opportunity here to extend the lead. Peters inbound again. For Jefferson to Morgan. They're going to give it back to each other, and now it's in the hands of Morgan. 13 minutes to play, second half. Asbury by 11. Morgan drives right side, and he draws the foul. It's going to be Moses. That's the sixth team foul now. It's the second foul on Moses, and the next foul will put Asbury in the bonus. We still got a lot of time here in the second half.
Great position for the Eagles to be in, as they're pretty solid free throw shooters.
Here's Christian Morgan with it. We'll throw it inside to Peters, and he's fouled. And now Asbury is in the bonus the rest of the way. It's going to be on Moses again. He's going to put a push in the back on Peters. They're going to have to bring in Will Massey now, as Moses picks up his third foul. Now Asbury will be in the bonus for a one-on-one situation. It'll be Dalton Peters at the line.
Asbury's in a great position with just under 13 minutes left in this half. They just need to maximize these opportunities now.
Peters' free throw is short. And it's rebounded by Harrington. Across to McCommons. 12:40 to play. Asbury still with an 11-point lead. Harrington to Massey. Back out to Butts. A long three. Well, short, but it's rebounded by Massey, but he throws it out into the hands of Morgan. Asbury's got numbers the other way. Peters, a nice pass. Gilbert probably should have shot that. Gave it back to Morgan. He'll swing it over to Jefferson. Good ball movement. Peters, he's feeling it. No good. Good look, though. Jefferson with the offensive rebound. Gilbert nearly got stripped. The ball is on the ground. It's going to be a – oh, no. CCU got the ball, and they called timeout. So with 12:07 left, Asbury comes away with nothing when they had a 3-on-1 advantage there, but it's still an 11-point lead with 12:07 left. It's going to be a 30-second timeout taken by Coach Zawadzki for CCU. It's his first year for the Eagles. Well, CCU still hasn't been scoring much, and Asbury's defense has really tightened up here in the second half. They've made everything very tough for Cincinnati Christian. They have not had really any good looks at all in the second half. And if they have had any, Asbury is forcing CCU to take three-pointers, and they're not falling at all, which is falling right into the hands of Asbury.
For me, this whole game comes down to rebounding. Honestly, CCU should be ashamed that they're getting out-rebounded right now. They are subbing in a 6'7 man for a 6'7 man for a 6'7 man. And our tallest man on the court right now is Todd Jefferson at about 6'4".
Yeah, absolutely. And you look at the stats. Asbury out-rebounding CCU by 7, 29-22. They're in the rebounding margin. Here's Harrington. Down to Commons. Over to Harrington. He'll take his first shot of the game. No good. He gets his own rebound. Swings it over to McCommons. Long three-pointer. Good. That would have been good from NBA range. And now the lead is single digits, 54-46 with 11:42 to go. Jefferson over to Gilbert. Back out to Gilbert. Morgan to Smith. Smith wants Morgan to set him a screen. Or Morgan wants Smith to set him a screen. Here's Morgan, kicks it over Jefferson. He's open, baseline three, good. Todd Jefferson drills the three. It's the 11th three-pointer tonight. 33 of Asbury's 57 points have come from beyond the arc, and it's been a huge factor here as Asbury once again extending their lead to double digits. 11:22 to go now. McCommons to bring it ahead for CCU. Here's McLeish. He's had a cold night from the floor, just 2 points. Asbury doing a great job harassing. There's Peters with the steal. Now Christian Morgan the other way. Morgan to drive left side. Svensson, a three. No good, rebounded by McCommons. There's McLeish going inside to Gaynor. And that's a nice move by Gaynor to draw the foul. Be the fourth team foul now on Asbury. It's a foul on Svensson. That's his second. Put Gaynor at the line for the Eagles. And Gainer, just a 68% free throw shooter, the junior out of Westchester, Ohio. Gets that first one to fall, 57-47, 10:48 to play. That free throw is no good, rebounded by Svensson. Just the third free throw taken from CCU tonight. Smith, over to Svensson. Back to Peters, who fumbled the ball. He'll swing it over to Gilbert now. Good pass to Smith, and an excellent job to convert on that. And a great pass from Jordan Gilbert. Now Asbury by a dozen with 10:22 to go. It's 59-47. Commons inside McLeish. Good pass inside Gainer. That was a good possession there from CCU. And good ball movement to find their big fella Gainer for the easy finish. Gainer now with double digits and 11 points. There's Svensson over to Gilbert. Back out to Peters now. Peters going to drive to the basket. Lost the ball, and I think it went off his hand, and it did. Turnover. And he'll head the other way now to CCU. The seventh turnover tonight on Asbury.
CCU gaining some momentum, getting on a run here. And we just need to see if Asbury can hold this run, sustain throughout it, and take over.
Commons swings it over to McLeish. We'll walk it across the half court line. As Massey, who just came back into the game, swings it back over to McCommons. Harrington, a three. He got it. They left him too open. Dalton Peters didn't really close in on him too much. Too much space, and Harrington knocks down the three. Fifth three-pointer tonight for CCU, and it's a seven-point game with 9:25 to play. Morgan crosses over, finds Smith. Morgan kicks it over to Will Henderson. Henderson drives baseline, bad pass. McLeish fighting for it, he comes up with it. Now in transition, McLeish driving. They're going to call a foul on Tyler Smith or either Dalton Peters. And they're going to call it on Smith for a hold. Fifth team foul now on the Eagles. Shooting fouls, two free throws from McLeish. Second foul on Tyler Smith. McLeish has had a struggling night, just 2 points. He'll take his first free throws of the game. He hits that one. 3 of 4 now for the line for CCU tonight. Second one is up and good. 5 point game now, 9:07. CCU starting to cut into this Asbury lead. It's Henderson. And he is fouled by McCommons. And that is now the eighth team foul, so that'll be bonus situation from the rest of the way. 25%. So Henderson at the line. Free throw is good. Asbury back up by 6 now. Shooting the free throws very well tonight, 11 of 14 from the line. Henderson knocks down both of them, the freshman out of Nicholasville, Kentucky. Asbury now up by 7. 8:50 to play. Here's Harrington. McLeish finds McCommons. Harrington, a three. Hit one there before. No good, but Gainer's there getting the putback. And it's back to 5 now. 61-56 with 8.5 left. Morgan driving left side. Over to Svensson. He picks up his dribble, and he will throw it off of Gainer, and it will stay with Asbury. Jefferson comes back in the game now for the Eagles, along with Jordan Gilbert. Henderson and Svensson will come out of the game. 8:18 to go. Asbury up by 5. Tyler Smith on a cut and an easy finish. Good job by Tyler Smith. He continues his monster game. Completion over to McCommons. We'll just kick it back to each other. 8 minutes to play. Massey with it. A reach-in foul. We're going to call it on Christian Morgan. Sixth team foul now. Next foul on Asbury will put CCU in the bonus. Take a look at that replay there. Excellent cut to the basket from Tyler Smith on that inbounds play. We got a timeout on the floor. I think Asbury called it. Coach Schaus calling timeout, full timeout. 7:59 to play here in the second half. Asbury 63, CCU 56. Asbury still holding on to that lead, Kylie. We saw it kind of slip a little bit, but it's still a 7-point lead. There's still a lot of time left, though. What does Asbury need to do to finish this game strong?
They need to continue to rebound. Saw CCU get some second chance points, which is expected with a 6-7 man underneath the basket. But Asbury's done a great job of controlling the energy of this game. Even when they haven't been controlling the pace necessarily, they're getting all the 50-50 balls. They're maximizing their opportunities. Anytime they get a layup opportunity, wide open layup, Smith maximizes. At the free throw line, they have to maximize on those opportunities. CCU, they've got some motivation now. They've got some energy from where they went on that run.
All right, so 7:59 to play. Now both teams headed back to the floor. It'll be CCU ball underneath the Asbury basket. Actually, they're going to take it out from the sideline. It'll be McCommons to inbound it to Harrington. Commons has space, decides not to take the three. Seibert picks up his dribble. Here's McLeish. Inside Gaynor. Double teamed and harassed by Jefferson and Morgan. Mid-range jumper from Seibert, no good. It's rebounded by Peters. Now to Morgan with 7:35 to play. Jordan Gilbert now to bring it up. Here's Morgan. Jefferson, he catches and shoots. Not quite there, a little too strong. In transition now. Harrington has it on the wing. Gaynor wants it inside, and Jefferson's going to be called for a foul, and that is now the seventh team foul. So 7:13 left. CCU will be shooting one in the bonus as well, along with Asbury. So every time we see a foul now, each team will head to the free throw line. Well, not much time off the clock, but we got another full timeout. It's taken by CCU. Asbury, like we said, with a couple points. Well, score still stays the same, actually. 63-56, 7:13 to go. We got a highlight package here.
We have the Dalton Peters highlight package here.
Well, that was Dalton Peters, like we said. Only Dalton Peters, but you know what? He's had a heck of a game. 17 points. Just really tremendous, and like you said, was this his first start of the night, or of the year? Yeah,
yes,
he's really played well. He's been a big part of Asbury's long-range shooting. Asbury's only made 11 three-pointers, and Peters has made half of them with five.
Peters only a freshman. He went to West Jessamine High School, and he was actually the 12th region player of the year in high school, so there's big expectations for him coming in, and we're seeing that tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. Definitely playing up to his potential. Still a lot of time left, 7:13 to go. Asbury, though, with a 63-56 lead. They are outscoring CCU here in the second half, 26-22. You look at that stat. Asbury, when leading at the half, is 15-2 on the year. So definitely the stats and everything are in their favor here. What's that? You want to read that? Oh, no, okay. Gaynor hits his first free throw. Asbury is 25-7 all time versus CCU. CCU's last win came back nearly 3 years ago. Here in the loose, 88-71. Gaynor knocks down both free throws. 5-point game, 7:10 to go. Gilbert across to Smith. There's Peters. Three-pointer, no good. Here McCommons now. Under 7 minutes to play. Harrington over to Seibert. Gainer wants it in the post. Working on Jefferson. He goes up with it, and he gets a second chance. He can't allow that. It's now a three-point game, 6:35 to go. Kenny Gaynor's been huge here in the second half. He now has 16 points. Christian Morgan. Stop and pop, no good. Morgan fights for a second rebound, gets it, and draws the foul. Christian Morgan has done an outstanding job tonight, driving to the basket and drawing fouls. Just great hustle there from Morgan. The sophomore out of Warsaw, Kentucky will go to the line. CCU's coach is very upset about that call. But as you can tell, the refs are clearly ignoring him. 64-60 now, 6:16 left. Morgan's second free throw, good. So a 5-point lead. Asbury doing an excellent job from the free throw line, 13-16 tonight. McLeish finds Seibert. Gonna go back to Gaynor. They kick it up to Seibert now. Three-pointer, no good. Rebounded by Tyler Smith. There's Gilbert. Three-pointer, too strong. It's going to be the last off of Dalton Peters, according to the officials. Crowd doesn't like the call. It'll be CCU ball. .552 to play. 65-60 Asbury. McCommons just throws it up. McLeish comes down with the offensive rebound. There's Gaynor. Jumper from the elbow. He got it. He's on fire. Kenny Gaynor, he's got 19 points now. It's a three-point game with 5:35 to play. Tyler Smith with it. Driving to the basket. Foul will be before the shot. But regardless now, with both teams being the bonus, Tyler Smith will go to the line for a 1-1 situation.
Asbury is now in the double bonus, actually, so great opportunity here.
Yeah, so two free throws for Tyler Smith. And Smith gets the free throw to go. Asbury doing an excellent job. Like I stated earlier, from the free throw line, that's their 15th made free throw out of 18 attempts. Smith knocks down both. 5:20 to go. Asbury by 5, 67-62. Here's Harrington. He's going to get a screen from Gaynor. And he's going to step back three-pointer. No good. Jordan Gilbert with the rebound. Ahead to Peters. And Dalton Peters converts. 19 points for the freshman.
Incredible finish by Peters there.
Gaynor the other way, and he draws the foul. We'll put Gaynor to the line for two free throws. We're going to call this foul on Todd Jefferson. Blocking foul, saying he wasn't set. He was trying to draw yet another charge. Well, CCU hasn't gone to the free throw line much tonight, but when they have, they've knocked down just about all of them. Gaynor hits that free throw. It's now 7 of 8 from the line as the team. Gaynor now has 20 points, a huge second half. It's now a 6-point deficit. Drew Shelton comes in for CCU. Gaynor's second free throw is short, and there's Tyler Smith with yet another rebound. Here's Christian Morgan. He's going to drive left side. Kind of forced that one. But it's last off CCU. Another opportunity again for Asbury.
With a 6-point lead, I'd like to see the Eagles use a little bit more of the shot clock. when they have possession of the ball.
Peters on the inbound to Christian Morgan. There's Gilbert, back out to Peters. Now Gilbert, very far out, almost thought about a three-pointer there. Smith will draw the foul, and he'll go to the line for two free throws.
Smith playing incredibly smart. He identifies it there in the double bonus, and he's looking to attack the rim.
It's the third foul now on McCommons. CCU's coach very upset still. He wants the official to call it both ways. Smith's free throw is no good. A rare miss tonight for Asbury. Puts him now at 16 of 20 as a team. Smith knocks down the second free throw, so Asbury now ahead 70-63, 4:20 to play. Here's McLeish, and yet another foul on the floor. A lot of fouls here in the past minute or so. That'll put Mitch McLeish at the line. Third foul on Todd Jefferson. Just the ninth team foul, though, for Asbury, so still 1-1. Situation here for Mitch McLeish. Just 4 points tonight for McLeish, the leading scorer for Asbury, or for CCU. Free throw no good. Rebound by Peters and out to Jordan Gilbert. Now Gilbert to slow it down on offense. Smith gives it over to Gilbert. 4 minutes to play. Asbury by 7. 70-63. Smith's going to look to try and beat Gaynor there, but he lost the ball. It's taken away Mitch McLeish in transition. McLeish, and he traveled. And that's a turnover. That's the 12th turnover tonight on for CCU. And a missed opportunity there. Asbury now gets the ball back. The chance to burn more clock. Jordan Gilbert now to bring it up. Christian Morgan heavily guarded by McLeish. Asbury really slowing it down now. Definitely the right move. Gilbert now going to kick it out. Peters, a three. It's good again, Dalton Peters. 6 3-pointers on the night and 22 points. For him, the freshman is on fire and a 10-point lead for Asbury with 3:19 to go.
I'd say the CCU coaching staff definitely wasn't expecting this game out of Dalton Peters.
So a full timeout taken for CCU with 3:19 left. Like we said, Dalton Peters absolutely on fire with 22 points. He's really been the biggest key outside of Tyler Smith for Asbury. But once again, like we said, it's really been just a total team effort for Asbury tonight. And I think it's really gotten into the heads of CCU, especially their coaching staff, more than their players probably. Their coaching staff just really seems disappointed with their team tonight. But you got to give credit to Asbury. They've totally dominated on offense and defense here in the second half, put all kinds of pressure on CCU. And, you know, CCU's not getting any really good looks on offense.
Well, they've had some great opportunities. You saw Mitch McLeish getting to the free throw line for an and one, and he doesn't finish on the free throw. Then he gets a steal. He has a pretty easy break and just unfortunately, fortunately for us, turns it over. There's got to be a lot of pressure, though, playing in your old gym.
Yeah, definitely. Kenny Gaynor really been the big player along with McCommons for CCU. Gaynor's been a big key for CCU's offense inside. 26 points in the paint for CCU. A lot of those have come from the big gun, Kenny Gaynor, the junior, standing at 6'7". He's been a big presence inside, and he's had a huge second half. But Asbury with a 10-point lead here with 3:19 left. McCommons to inbound. Not a whole lot of time left. Commons now to walk it up the floor. Over to McLeish. Asbury now in intense man-to-man defense. Good pass from Shelton. He finds Siebert, a three, no good. going to be last off of Shelton. It'll be Asbury ball, 2:57 left. Smith gives it out to Jordan Gilbert now. Here's Todd Jefferson. Asbury really milking the clock. 2:32 to go. 10 seconds now on the shot clock. Gilbert gonna drive. Throws up a shot, it's short, but it goes into the hands of Dalton Peters. And Asbury's gonna slow down the clock again. Here's Smith. He's gonna pull up jumper, it's short.
Not the shot you want there with the shot clock in your favor.
Yeah, absolutely. You can tell Coach Schaus very upset that Smith took that shot. Three-pointer no good from a Commons. Jefferson with the rebound. Just 2 minutes left. Asbury up by 10. Back out to Gilbert to slow it down. He's going to swing it over to Christian Morgan. .140 to go. 10 seconds now on the shot clock. Morgan going to drive left side. Here's Peters. Double clutch, tough look there. Couldn't get it. Kenny Gaynor with the rebound. Here's McLeish the other way. McCommons on the push. And Seibert, and that is an and one play with 1:24 left. CCU trying to make a big comeback here. It's an 8-point game now. We'll put Seibert at the line.
Again, we see Asbury not getting back in transition, which they got into that habit there towards the end of the first half.
Yeah. Good job, though, from Seibert to draw the foul. Second foul on Christian Morgan.
In a moment like this, where you have the lead and you have the advantage, you want to drop back and protect your territory.
Missed free throw, though, and it's rebounded by Tyler Smith yet again. He's got to have almost 20 rebounds. Our stats are kind of slow on this, but he had about 15 earlier. Christian Morgan drives to the basket and draws yet another foul, and he'll go to the line for two free throws.
Once again, glad he drew that foul, but probably not the best decision-making there with only a minute 13 on the clock and an 8-point lead.
CCU doing mass subbing to let their offensive scorers who are in foul trouble get some rest and not foul so they can put in their bench players to play defense. So McCommons, McLeish, and Shelton all come back in for CCU. Morgan hits the free throw. It's a 9-point lead. 7 points on the night for Christian Morgan. Second one is good as well. 75-65 with 1:13 to play. Time running out now on CCU. Shelton out to McCommons. Shelton gives it to McLeish. McLeish throws up a three, no good. Seibert saves it to Gaynor. His three-pointer short, ball's on the ground. It's going to be a jump ball. CCU's coaching staff very upset at that. 50.2 to go. Possession arrow favors Asbury.
I'd say CCU's coaching staff is a little bit more upset about the predictable outcome of this game now. With 50.2 seconds left, if Asbury plays intelligently, they should come out with a victory.
Tyler Smith inbound to Jordan Gilbert. He'll bring it across. 45 seconds left. Asbury leading 75-65. Now a foul. We'll put Christian Morgan at the line. It'll be on Denzel Harrington. His second. CCU going to continue to sub in multiple players. It's going to be McCommons, Butts, and McLeish getting ready to come back in. Morgan missed the free throw. Just the fifth missed free throw tonight for Asbury. 19-24 from the line. Come on, come on. So Morgan hits the second free throw. Asbury by 11, a 30-second timeout taken by Coach Schaus. 43 seconds left, though. This thing's pretty much in the books, despite a major collapse for Asbury. The Eagles have done an excellent job to maintain their composure in the second half, harassing CCU on the defensive end, and also have done an excellent job knocking down threes. 12 three-pointers made tonight for Asbury. They've outscored CCU 39-31 as well. Biggest players on the floor for the Eagles tonight, Tyler Smith and Dalton Peters, the freshman, with 22 points. So CCU is going to have a couple more chances to throw up some shots. This thing is pretty much in the books. And Butts just throws it away, and a turnover with 37.7 to go. I imagine Asbury will just hold the ball here, either force CCU to foul him or just take the clock all the way down to a couple seconds. And there's a foul from Seibert. We'll put Gilbert at the line.
Gilbert is definitely the person you'd like to go to the free throw line. Excellent shooter.
Nice game tonight from Jordan Gilbert, 11 points. Free throw is good. And a 12-point lead. A big win here tonight for Asbury. This will put them in first place in the KIAC South Division. And we'll drop CCU to second now. Not for sure a whole lot of people thought this win would happen outside of the Asbury Eagles basketball team being down their two best scorers. But it's a 13-point lead, 30 seconds left. McCommons will pull up three, too strong. Rebounded by Tyler Smith yet again. And Smith is fouled. They're going to call it on McCommons. With 22.7 left, this thing is pretty much over now.
Coach Schaus has to be so proud of his team. They're able to overcome having their two main players out. They have two starters. Todd has only started two games this season. And Dalton Peters, his first start of the season. And wow, what a game with 22 points, 6 three-pointers.
Absolutely. Coach Schaus has to be thrilled with this performance from his team. Especially in a big game like this with both teams fighting for sole place of that division. CCU only had four players on the floor. So checking in will be Alex Terry, the freshman, for the first time tonight. Smith's free throw is up. Just nicks the rim, no good.
He has to be exhausted with 18 points and 17 rebounds.
Yeah, he's played most of the game as well. He's definitely got to be tired. Fortunately, that missed free throw didn't matter. There's Smith banking in the free throw. Under 20 seconds left, a 14-point lead. McLeish, a long three. He got it. Surprised that they didn't call the foul there, but it won't matter. 14 seconds. Gilbert gets it across to Peters. Smith to hold it. CCU's coach telling his team no foul, and that'll be it. 5 seconds left, and the clock will run out. Asbury going to get the win, 79-68, a huge win. It'll put Asbury now in first place with an 18-7 record now overall and a 7-2 record in KIAC South Division. They are now back in front. A huge game tonight for Asbury. Like we said, a total team effort. Big games from Dalton Peters and Tyler Smith especially, but you got to look at Todd Jefferson and Jordan Gilbert as well, also getting into double figures. Asbury did an excellent job of slowing down Mitch McLeish, their leading scorer for CCU. They held him to just 7 points. McCommons had 17 for CCU, and Kenny Gaynor was their biggest player with 20 points on the night. So,
congratulations on this win. Incredible game. You've got to be so proud of your team. What did your team do tonight that made the difference?
Well, they stuck to a game plan. We put it together, and we were really rolling the dice. We, missing Kyle Lamb and missing C.J. Penny. So we were without a lot of points tonight, a lot of leadership, but some guys stepped up. We've been preaching for them. Somebody's got to step up. Somebody's got to step up. And what a game by Dalton Peters. I haven't looked at the stats. We had a lot of guys that played well, but, Dalton Peters, I thought, really stepped up and played well. We've been wanting him to do that for a while.
The two players that really stood out to me, once again, Dalton Peters with 6 3-pointers, finishing with 22 points. But Tyler Smith, he got 18 rebounds, and he finished with 18 points. Talk about what he has to do on this team now with both CJ and Kyle out.
Well, we're really undersized. We were undersized to begin with CJ in, and now we're really undersized. So he's going to have to get more boards. He's going to have to be more aggressive. He's kind of our motor anyway, him and K-Mo are, and he I'm just so proud of him tonight. And the big thing with him, he's got to stay fresh, and we need to bring him out of the game for a couple minutes. And he called for it. Alex Dennis goes in, gets a basket, gets a rebound. And you know what? That gave him the amount of time to get his rest, and I think there was a timeout right there. So really spacing out and getting him the rest he needed was good.
It's obvious to everybody that this is a really special team. They continuously fight and battle despite the multiple obstacles that have been thrown at them, especially here in the last couple of weeks. Talk about how this team compares to the teams you've had in the past and the advantage that they have over other teams in the conference because of their competitive nature.
Well, the conference is what the conference is. Very good. There's no nights off. As far as compared to the teams, I have favorites. Favorite players over time. They're all my favorites, I guess. But this group is right here now. They are playing so hard and with so much heart. It would be easy to say, we got a couple of injuries. We can just fold up our tents and get ready for next year. No, they are here to play, and they want to make some noise in the conference tournament and the rest of the schedule.
Well, congratulations on the win, and good luck the rest of the season.
Thanks, Kyle.
All right, so Asbury with the 70-96 day win. We now have a highlight package from the highlights from the second half, so take a look. That's the story here from Wilmore. A huge win for Asbury. So alongside with Kylie Gorby, I'm Daniel Harris. Thank you for watching Asbury Basketball, and we'll see you next time.